I'm doing a series of speeches, not a speech of conscience. This is my second speech dealing with the fact that humans are a species of consciousness, not instinct. Even though humans have genes like other species, humans are not controlled by the genes like a species of instincts are. So, this means that humans are not smart animals, as liberals have known to advocate that humans are. In my first speech, Ari Armstrong noted to me in the evaluation that dogs also have consciousness. That's true. That's very true. Dogs do have consciousness. But dogs are not aware that they are aware. Your dog's not going to get up at 5:30 in the morning, right? Who's getting the dog up at 5:30 in the morning walking? You are. Not the dog. And well, we don't know what cats are. So, being a species of consciousness, we have two primary advantages over species of instinct. The first primary advantage is that we can decide, analyze, remember, evaluate, and evaluate nature. And the second is that we can create new things. No species of instinct can do any of these. But this does not preclude us from following the rules of nature. This ability to determine the laws of nature, whether we like the results or not, because many of us would love them to be able to jump 50 or 60 feet in the air. And as with any creature, each human has a set of abilities. But unlike other creatures, humans can improve their abilities and create totally new abilities. These abilities allow us to be much smarter than other creatures. And the human with the lowest intelligence still smarter than the creature with the highest intelligence. There are many humans, though not in this room, that think that because we are so much more intelligent than animals, that we are God, which causes us huge problems. First of all, the first thing to deal with is that the scientific method is based on our ability to decide, analyze, remember, and to evaluate nature. The Oxford English Dictionary defines the scientific method as a method or procedure consisting of a systematic observation, measurement, and experiment, formulation, testing, and modification of hypotheses. If humans were a species of instinct, we would not be able to decide, analyze, remember, or evaluate nature in a systematic way. If we could not do that, we could not develop any bodies of knowledge, nor could we create any new knowledges. Now, as with the species of instinct, each human has a particular set of abilities. They are human abilities. I'm sure in your conversations you've discussed them all. And, you know, so we each have a range of abilities. And therefore, actually, the bell curve applies. But unlike animals, humans can improve their abilities and their position on the bell curve. Humans learn by doing, remembering, by being mentors to others, and by studying others through visual images and language, symbology. No animal has this ability. So, gives us great capabilities. Being a species, a conscious we have known to be arrogant. Really? Because of our great abilities, there's a large percentage of us think that we are God instead of being one of the many species that God has created. Since we are one of many species that God has created, we humans are subject to the laws of nature like any other species. Our ability to analyze, dissect, the principles of nature, not include us following the laws of nature. So all laws of nature apply to a species of instinct as also applied to a species of consciousness. So competition, specialization, cooperation, exploration, learning will apply to a species of consciousness as much as they apply to a species of instinct. Additionally, like any other species of nature, we use the resources of nature. But since we can analyze nature, we can mix coal and iron and get steel. We can turn oil into plastics. Some of you know this. Tupperware we've got around here. But this doesn't make us gods. Many liberals think that because we can analyze nature, we can control nature. Well, the tornadoes in the Midwest have shown that we can't control nature. But liberals apply the same thought frame to society and economics. And Louise gave some examples in his speech. As a result, liberals and others of their ilk think that we can play God by analyzing nature. But check it out. The destruction of a functioning black culture devastated inner cities. Close to 40% out of wedlock births, a tremendous poverty that's caused by the rate, and 25 out of 25 in student achievement for the developed countries. I could go on and on. And Louise also, in his speech, provided other great examples. So I don't need to go on with that. But to, you know, summarize, humans, as a species of consciousness, are part of nature, as a species of instinct are. Therefore, to be successful, we must follow the rules of nature, as individuals, as societies, and as civilizations, or else we all fail. So, if you wish to be successful, follow the rules of nature. Thank you very much.